Quite a few no-code website builders have incorporated generative AI into their user flow, and some of them are making pretty bold claims. One of them says you can get up and running in seconds. Let's see how much of this is just marketing. In this video, I'll test how helpful generative AI is for website building. I've covered generative AI in app building. My overall impression was that it significantly sped up early stage app development. You can check out the video here. But what about websites? Practically any online business will benefit from having its own website, but not every business owner has the time or patience to build a website, even if it's just drag and drop. So the premise of an AI-generated site sounds appealing. Zero effort on your part, and you still get a great site, right? Let's see. The website builder. The website builder I'm using is called Framer. They've been around since 2013. They are VC-funded. What I'm trying to say is they're established. In June 2023, they released a feature called Start with AI, where you start your project by typing in what you want in the text box. The official Framer description says you can use this, and I quote, as a brand new way to get up and running in seconds. Then I watched a video from their team explaining how to properly use Start with AI, and I would like to share this part.
Here is best to avoid extra short descriptions and add as many details as possible about the content of our site. There is an indicator just below the text that shows how exhaustive a prompt is. Try to fill the bar, making the description as complete as possible.
Okay, you heard the soothing Italian voice. Provide key details, try to fill in the bar at the bottom of the box. So I'll provide three prompts asking for the same thing, each time adding more details. If Start with AI is any good, there should be a difference. I should be getting a better and better website generated for me. And the bigger question, will any of these websites be launch ready immediately? Will they be up and running in seconds? My three prompts. I'm going to ask Framer AI to build me a website advertising my development services. Don't tell my boss I'm doing side gigs, by the way. He's a real asshole. I asked ChatGPT for help. Explain what I needed and got three levels of prompts to try out. We've got a basic prompt, a medium detail prompt, and a high detail prompt. I can easily see that first level of prompt being what everyone first tries out. The medium level prompt is probably what a lot of people will quickly learn to do. But the high detail one will be far more useful if the AI can appreciate the difference and deliver. Okay, let's get to work. And by that, I mean, let's get the AI to work. Low detail prompt. So here's the low detail one. We can see the detail bar at the bottom is barely half filled, which means this will surely end well. While waiting for the site to fully load, we can play around with the color combinations. I can't really see a developer using bright colors. We only exist in dark mode. Anyways, the site isn't much more than a template. I'll give it a 3 out of 10. Medium detail prompt. Okay, at least now we're maxing out the bottom bar. And I'm not crazy about the color scheme, but in terms of details, it's much more complete. It has some key stats that potential clients will look out for. I really don't think I'm gonna get leads with a radioactive color scheme, but I'll give this a 3.5 out of 10. High detail prompt. This one has a lot of extra details. Like I've asked for a portfolio section to show off my work, and I've specified that I've managed a remote working team before. Okay, now we're getting somewhere. Decent layout, key details all match up. And I'll have to add in the specific pictures, but the sections are all there for me. I'll give this a 4 out of 10. I think there are two takeaways here. Let's get to them. Hey guys, if you like this video, then please like this video, literally click like and subscribe. Thanks. First takeaway, requirements gathering is super important. You saw how much better the result was when I put in more effort into explaining what I wanted. And I even made that process faster by getting ChatGPT to help me write the actual prompts. So if you're going to use AI to build a website, the more thought you put into planning and prompting, the less work you end up having to do to get the website ready to launch. And that's really the second takeaway. Up and running is not launch ready. I would say my third prompt was very detailed and I still got a 4 out of 10 site. Would I use a 4 out of 10 site? No. I think it's just because Framer is using a text-based AI model, which means they are probably predefining templates on the backend. AI isn't actually generating a website for you. AI is just mixing and matching from existing blocks. To be fair, the copy is probably generated, but that's about it. I think getting this much out of a prompt is useful, but be prepared to put in manual work. And that's fine, because the rest of Framer is good enough. I think it's comprehensive enough to build a responsive website for your business. Outside of Start with AI, it has the usual features you'd want in a no-code website builder. And if you want a proper site, you still need to make use of them. You can start with AI, but you need to finish by yourself. My verdict on Framer AI. Would I use Framer AI personally? I might. Would I use it if it didn't come with the rest of Framer? Probably not. The nature of my industry means I need more flexibility and control over my websites than the average business owner. And while Framer as a whole can definitely offer me that, Framer AI by itself falls a bit short. As you saw, you need time to plan your prompt and get the most out of the AI generator. The up and running in seconds claim isn't untrue. I got a customized design in under a minute. Customized is being quite generous, but I'm a generous guy. Even then, a human will need to get their hands dirty to get a website that's truly customized. That seems to be the story with OpenAI integrations everywhere. It can help make a product work better, but only if that product already worked great before. So that's my thought on AI in website building. It helps, but it's not even close to doing everything. And so, if AI assistance is important to you, make sure the rest of the platform already offers you what you need. Ideally, make sure you can do it yourself. And AI just becomes a great bonus to have. Think of it more as an unpaid intern you can abuse rather than an expert you bent over backwards to please. If you click on this video, I'm guessing you're looking for a no-code website builder and you thought an AI generator sounded pretty good. I hope this video gave a better perspective of what to expect out of AI. It's no miracle worker. And you know, there are lots of website builders out there that cater to really specific niches. Check out this video where I recommend 4 different low-code website builders for 4 different use cases. One of them costs less than $2 a month for a full-fledged website. Some of these builders charge you $2 every time you breathe. If you found this useful, please subscribe for more content like this every week. I mostly cover apps, but websites get covered too. It's all related. So yeah, subscribe, leave a like, and leave a comment below. What has been your experience with AI website builders? Let's jump into those recommendations. Cheers!